So you're operating your business as a sole proprietor, but you keep hearing people tell you to start an LLC. And all you can think of is, what does that mean and why would I want to do that? Keep watching, because that's what we're talking about today. So first things first, hashtag not a lawyer. So I am not giving legal advice here. But this is what I know based off forming my own business as an entrepreneur myself and helping my tax clients form their businesses along the way and working with their attorneys. So what I'm telling you guys today, not legal advice, not even technically tax advice, but guidance in as you're starting your business or maybe thinking about taking your business from a sole prop to a single member LLC. Let's start by defining what a sole proprietor is. So when we say the word sole proprietor, you also hear sole prop, independent contractor, self-employed, 1099 contractor. You hear the word 1099 employee, which isn't right, but that's the accountant in me. We'll just go with it. All of these things mean the same thing. It's anyone who's providing a good or a service in exchange for money or in an attempt to run a business. All right, and a sole proprietor is one who's running this business under their social security number. So you may or may not have what's called a DBA, doing business as. So you may or may not have an actual business name, but if you're running your business under your social, then you're a sole prop. All right, so for example, I might just be giving my social security number to my clients and saying, make your checks to Bree Beers, or maybe I set up a DBA that says Bree Beers Accounting. All right, even if I have a DBA, if it's under my social security number, sole prop. So out there, most of my gig workers, my Uber drivers, my Lyft drivers, my DoorDash drivers, y'all are sole proprietors, typically, because you're receiving your money to your social security number. If you receive your 1099 NEC to your social, sole prop. Bottom line is, if you haven't caught on by now, if your business is running under your social, sole prop. At this point, if you recognize that yes, my business is a sole proprietor, but you have not been asked at least 1,000 times if you're gonna form an LLC, it's going to happen. People are going to ask you as you grow your business. So let's just talk about today what that means and if it's something that you would consider as your business grows. Okay, so when you're in business for and by yourself, right? Again, you might consider creating an LLC, turning your business into an LLC. What does that mean? It really just means that you're turning your business into what's called a single member LLC. That's the, not the legal term, but the, that's what you are, single member LLC. Creating a single member LLC for your business does a lot of really good things for you as a business owner. First, it allows you to run your business without sharing your social security number with the people who are paying you. So when we talked about above, when you're a sole proprietor, you get paid under your social, which means you're providing your social security number to others. When you set up as an LLC, you're gonna get a tax ID number that's separate from your social security number. So you'll then provide your tax ID number to those paying you and you'll get paid under that. So for a lot of people, it adds a little bit of security. You guys, it also allows you to pick a name that might feel a little more official or a little more professional, and having a tax ID number and an LLC does look more professional to the people you're working with. So it's gonna look more professional to your vendors, to your customers, to your potential partners, lenders. Lenders love an LLC. I know a lot of people who try to get a business bank account under their social, and banks are like, that's not a thing. You have to have, a lot of banks tell you, you have to have a tax ID number, an LLC, a separate business entity, in order to get a business account. So setting up that LLC sometimes makes it easier for you to get the tools you need to operate your business more efficiently. Most importantly, and again, hashtag not a lawyer, setting up an LLC keeps your business separate from your personal. So what that means is if somebody sues your business, they can only go after what your business owns. Okay, they can't go after you personally. We talk about a term called corporate veil. It keeps, the corporate veil is what keeps your business separate from your personal. So a lot of people set up an LLC for the pure legal separation benefit. And I will always, always advise you to consult with an attorney when you're setting up a new business. All right, although I do have a lot of clients who don't use a lawyer, but I'm going to tell you to use one to ask these questions about whether an LLC is right for you. So now let's talk about the cons of setting up an LLC versus continuing to operate as a sole proprietor. So first of all, there is some setup. So in order to become an LLC, you have to file with your Secretary of State. You have to get a tax ID number for your business, typically. The other main con is that when you register with your Secretary of State, there is a fee to register. It varies state to state. And there is an annual renewal that happens that's going to add that added cost to running your business. But for most states, this cost, you guys, is minimal. In Colorado, it's $50 to register with your Secretary of State, and then I believe it's $10 every year to renew. So it's very inexpensive here. I know a lot of states, or some states that are in the hundreds, and so that does play into your decision. But honestly, you guys, the pros, I believe, outweigh the cons so much that no matter what that cost is, I think that the pros of setting up this LLC far outweigh the cons of extra work and a couple extra dollars. So, again, not a lawyer, but that is my professional business owner opinion. If you guys have any questions about what we talked about today, go ahead and leave a comment below. And then I highly, highly suggest you head on over to our Facebook community, Money, Taxes, and Finance for Small Business, because these topics are what we talk about on a regular basis and have live trainings on every week. You can access that group by clicking the link in the description box. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and while you're loving on me hard, go ahead and hit the notification bell so you never miss a future video.